Hello dear learners, today we are going to talk about Hydantoin. From Hydantoin class, we are going to talk about the drug Phenytoin. Phenytoin belongs to the class Hydantoin, which is an anti-epileptic drug. So, in continuation with the last two parts, in first part we covered all the types of epilepsy. And in second part, we covered the trick to remember the classification of anti-epileptic drugs. So, to coming towards the today's third part, that is Hydantoin, the first class from anti-epileptic drug, from that, the drug of choice, that is Phenytoin. So, to start with the Phenytoin, first, we will cover the structure, its IUPAC. Along with the structure IUPAC, we are going to talk about its properties, uses, official preparations and brand names. So, to start with the Phenytoin structure, first we have to understand what is Hydantoin, because Phenytoin belongs to the class Hydantoin. Now, Hydantoin is nothing but imidazolidine 2,4-dione. So, as you can see here in the structure, this is imidazolidine 2,4-dione. In our previous video lectures, from nomenclature of heterocyclic compounds, classification of heterocyclic compounds, from those videos, we are up to this level that we can understand the 5-membered, 6-membered and fused ring structures. So, according to that, the first structure which you can see here, this is imidazole. So, imidazole, how you will remember that? It is dazole. So, it is 2-azo. Aza is nothing but nitrogen. So, as you can see here in the structure, it is dazole. So, it is 1 and 2 nitrogens are there. Then, imi ka I is 1. And then 3 alphabets. So, it is first and third position. Matlab, first position pe I hai naam mein and third position pe I hai. So, nitrogen bhi structure mein first position pe hai and third position pe hai. So, this is imidazole. So, ole is the suffix which is used for 5-membered unsaturated structures. So, 5-membered unsaturated rings are known by the suffix, or they are written by the suffix ole. And da-azo means 2 nitrogens, and in the name at first position I is there and at third position I is there. So, it is first and third position. So, this is the structure of imidazole. So, ole, since it is an unsaturated form, we are converting it to the saturated form. So, when one bond, that is between, as you can see here, it is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. So, when the double bond between 4th and 5th position will go and the saturation will come, at that time the structure will become imidazoline. And imidazoline INE. So, here in 3rd structure, as you can see, when again it is converted to a complete saturated form, from unsaturated form, like that means, here the double bond, this double bond will also go. So, this will give you the structure of imidazolidine. Now, imidazolidine structure, it is diene. Okay? So, it is olene, 1-INE. So, from imidazole, we are making imidazoline, that means imidazole. When it is converted to saturated form, it is zoline, and when it is converted to complete saturated form, it is imidazolidine. So, imidazolidine 2,4-dione is nothing but Hydantoin. So, what is remaining now? Imidazolidine we have obtained. Now, 2,4-dione is remaining. So, now when you number it, the numbering says like it is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, like 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. Okay. So, here this 2nd position and this 4th position should contain dione. At that time it will become dione. So, it is imidazoline we will take here, and at second place and fourth place tyone will come 2 ones, so it will become 2,4 dione. So imidazolidine ring pe jab second and fourth position pe, like series here 1, 2, 3, 4, so when it is on second and fourth position 2 keto, so it is 2,4 dione. Imidazolidine 2,4 dione. Now this imidazolidine 2,4 dione is nothing but our hydantoin. So now this hydantoin, when the two phenyl groups at fifth position, see this fifth position I have highlighted, this is first, second, third, fourth and fifth, when at fifth position two phenyls will be attached, this will be called as 5,5-diphenyl. So remaining part is what? It is imidazolidine 2,4 dione. So we are up with IUPAC also and the structure of phenytoin also from the evolution of hydantoin. That is, when at imidazolidine 2,4 dione's fifth position two phenyls will get attached, the name will become 5,5-diphenyl imidazolidine 2,4 dione. So it is nothing but phenytoin, which can also be written as 5,5-diphenyl hydantoin. Why? Because imidazolidine 2,4 dione is nothing but hydantoin. So this part we have covered with the structure and IUPAC, and when it exists with the sodium salt form, it is known as phenytoin sodium. Now we will see the structure, that this is hydantoin, this is nothing but imidazolidine 2,4 dione, and at fifth position, see this, you can see here two phenyls, so it is phenytoin. Now this is the general structure they have given. Okay, this is R1, R2, R3. When this R1 and this R1 is hydrogen, see here, as you can see, it is hydrogen, and then R2 and R3, which is at fifth position, so that fifth position R1 and R2 is nothing but C6H5, and it will give you phenytoin, and these are the other members of the hydantoin class. Mephenytoin is there, phenytoin is there. Okay, so mephenytoin mein here CH3 will come, and one substituent is phenyl from this and one is ethyl from this, which will give you mephenytoin, which is a derivative of hydantoin. So coming towards the properties of phenytoin, phenytoin is nothing but white crystalline powder, that is WCP, and it is odorless. Coming towards the solubility, it is practically insoluble in water, and it is slightly soluble in organic solvents such as alcohol, ether, chloroform, etc. And its sodium salt, see, as you can see here, this is the structure of phenytoin sodium. Everything is same, only here it is a double bond O ke saath sodium hai, ya fir dot sodium. So this sodium salt is official in various reference books like Indian Pharmacopoeia, British Pharmacopoeia and United States Pharmacopoeia, IPBP, USP. Sodium salt of phenytoin is official in IPBP and USP. And the property is, it is absorbing the moisture from the atmosphere and carbon dioxide on exposure to air. So it absorbs moisture as well as carbon dioxide when it is exposed to air. So these are the properties of phenytoin. Coming towards the next part, that is mechanism of action. In mechanism of action, as you can see, first we will go through the diagram. As you can see here in the diagram, these are voltage gated sodium channels, and this red mark is nothing but inhibitory mark. So what happens over here, it is, now from this image it is very much clear that it is something which is to be dealt with the voltage gated sodium channel, and this red mark indicates the inhibition. So what actually happens, we will see here. Now here what will happen, the neuronal sodium concentration will decrease. Why? Because voltage dependent sodium channel permeability to sodium ions decreases in the neuronal membrane. So which will give the stabilizing effect. Why? Because in epileptic patient, you all know that excited state is there. So to reduce this hyperexcitability, we need a stabilizing effect. So how it will work on? By decreasing the permeability of the sodium ion. And since sodium ion permeability decreases, there will be reduced sodium ion concentration. And because of this reduced sodium ion concentration, PTP, that is post-tetanic potentiation, will decrease. Due to decrease in the post-tetanic potentiation, it will increase the frequency of excitatory post-synaptic potential. That means the post-synaptic neuron will fire the action potential. So this EPSP working will be enhanced, which is responsible for spread of seizure activity and inhibit the spread of seizure discharge in the brain. Which will shorten the duration after discharge. So mechanism of action is major is it will decrease the permeability of the sodium ion, producing the stabilizing effect in the neuronal membrane, because epileptic patient needs to be calmed, needs to be stabilized, since the patient is already in the excited state. Then next we will see the uses of phenytoin. In case of uses of phenytoin, here it is treatment of grand mal epilepsy, treatment of generalized epilepsy, that is tonic clonic here, this is the first. Then it is also effective in partial seizures like psychomotor seizure, that is complex partial seizure, which is often called as temporal lobe epilepsy. But it is not effective against absent seizure. So as you can see here, it is effective against tonic clonic seizures also, partial seizures also, status epilepticus also, but it is not effective against the absent seizure. So this point is really very important, which you should remember, wherein MCQ can be asked that uses of phenytoin, like in which type of epilepsy phenytoin is not effective. So the answer is it is absent seizures, which are also known as petit mal seizures. Along with that, it is also effective in cardiac arrhythmia and trigeminal neuralgia. So what is trigeminal neuralgia? As you all know, trigeminal nerve is the nerve which carries the sensation from the face to brain. So what happens here in trigeminal neuralgia? It is a chronic pain condition which will affect the trigeminal nerve. So here, instead of phenytoin, carbamazepine is preferred in such neuralgia. It is the drug of second choice in case of trigeminal neuralgia. But it is the first line drug in treatment of grand mal, that is tonic clonic epilepsy, then partial seizures, that is psychomotor seizures, and status epilepticus. Now status epilepticus is nothing but it is a severe form of epilepsy which can be life threatening, wherein what happens, a single seizure can last more than 5 minutes, or two or more seizures within 5 minutes will appear without person returning to normal between them. Like it can last up to 30 minutes also, and it's an emergency condition, generally needs to be treated immediately. So this is status epilepticus. It is effective in status epilepticus also, but not effective against absent seizure. So this you all are supposed to remember. This is the characteristic about the uses of phenytoin, which is really very important from the competitive exam points of view also. Then coming towards the side effects, just a simple short trick is hot meal. As you can see here, it is hot meal, G and K, जी के है जी के, सो जी एंड के. सो हॉटमेल में एच स्टैंड्स फॉर हिर्सुटिज्म, ओ स्टैंड्स फॉर ऑस्टियोमलेशिया, टी स्टैंड्स फॉर टेराटोजेनिक इफेक्ट के दैट इज फीटस टॉक्सिसिटी, देन एम स्टैंड्स फॉर मेगालोब्लास्टिक एनीमिया, देन ए स्टैंड्स फॉर अरिदमिया विच इज एट टॉक्सिक डोसेस, आई स्टैंड्स फॉर इनहिबिटिंग द इंसुलिन रिलीज, एल स्टैंड्स फॉर लिम्फोएडिनोपैथी ओके, एंड जी के का जी स्टैंड्स फॉर गम हाइपरट्रोफी, के स्टैंड्स फॉर विटामिन के डिफिशियंसी, एंड का ए स्टैंड्स फॉर अटैक्सिया, देन एन इज निस्टैग्मस एंड डी इज डिप्लोपिया. सो ऑल दीज एंड आर एट टॉक्सिक डोसेस. सो दिस इज अ सिंपल शॉर्ट ट्रिक टू रिमेंबर द साइड इफेक्ट्स. इन PC2 वी डिड नॉट नीड दिस साइड इफेक्ट्स बिकॉज इट इज नो क्वेश्चन, देर इज नो क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम अबाउट द साइड इफेक्ट्स, बट दिस इज द सिंपल शॉर्ट ट्रिक विच आई गॉट, सो आई हैव इंक्लूडेड इन द नोट ऑफ फेनाइटोइन. देन नेक्स्ट इज ऑफिशियल प्रिपरेशंस ऑफ फेनाइटोइन. नाउ सिंस वी हैव सीन इन द प्रॉपर्टी दैट द सोडियम सॉल्ट इज ऑफिशियल इन IP, BP एज वेल एज USP, सो हियर एज यू कैन सी फेनाइटोइन सोडियम इंजेक्शन, इट इज अवेलेबल इन इंजेक्शन फॉर्म, सस्पेंशन फॉर्म, कैप्सूल फॉर्म ओके. सो इट इज फेनाइटोइन सोडियम इंजेक्शन IP एंड BP विच इज देयर इन द एम्प्यूल फॉर्म विच यू कैन सी हियर, देन फेनाइटोइन सोडियम ओरल सस्पेंशन विच इज ऑफिशियल इन IP एंड BP एज यू कैन सी हियर, सी फेनाइटोइन ओरल सस्पेंशन IP विच इज मार्केटेड अंडर द ब्रांड नेम एप्टोइन, देन फेनाइटोइन कैप्सूल IP एंड BP विच इज मार्केटेड अंडर द ब्रांड डाइलैंटीन. सो फेनाइटोइन कैप्सूल दैट इज डाइलैंटीन ऑफिशियल इन IP एंड BP, फेनाइटोइन सोडियम ओरल सस्पेंशन विच इज मार्केटेड अंडर द ब्रांड नेम एप्टोइन, एंड फेनाइटोइन सोडियम इंजेक्शन IP एंड BP विच इज मार्केटेड अंडर द नेम फेनाइटोइन इंजेक्शन BP. सो दीज आर फ्यू ऑफ द ऑफिशियल प्रिपरेशंस एंड ब्रांड्स. द ब्रांड नेम्स एज यू कैन सी हियर जस्ट नाउ ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन दैट एप्टोइन इज देयर, डाइलैंटीन इज देयर, देन एपिटीन, देन एप्सोटोइन, ऑल दीज यू कैन सी हियर इन द इमेजेस. द ब्रांड नेम्स आर, लिसन टू द ब्रांड नेम्स केयरफुली, एप्टोइन, डाइलैंटीन, एप्सोलिन, देन कैप्सील्स, फेनाइटेक, एपिसॉल प्लस, एपीलैन, एपिलेप्टीन, एपीफेन, देन एलिटियन प्लस, एलिटियन फोर्ट, एपिक्योर, एपीलैन सी, डाइलैंटीन पी. सो दीज आर वेरियस ब्रांड्स, अमॉन्ग दैट यू कैन जस्ट एनलिस्ट फ्यू ऑफ देम. Like the easy to remember are Eptoin is there, then Dilantin is there, Epsolin is there, Episol is there, Epilan is there, Epileptin is there. So these are few of the brands which you can remember easily. With this we finish with the very important anti-epileptic drug that is Phenytoin, which is from class Hydantoin. Thank you.